here at Phillips.
By McGillis, Vernon the save, and trying to bank it in was Lindros. Vernon was up to that. In front, Lindros poking at it! He scores! The light goes on! Lindros says he's got the goal. Keith Jones right in the middle of things. But it looks as though the Flyers have made it 2-1, although Lindros is talking with Terry Gregson. The light went on. But Gregson never did signal completely that it was a goal.
I think they're going to go upstairs, Jimmy. I don't think there's any indication right now from Terry Gregson whatsoever. He's going to say, guess what, boys? I'm going up. I'm not sure. He's not making any indication. John LeClair and Mike Vernon having some words. There's not a lot of excitement in that face right now as he's a little worried that that goal, whether it is or not.
Now, maybe we can have a look at it and see if it went in prior to going upstairs, but there's a mad scramble in front of the net. Some, again, excellent work by John LeClair. Yeah, I can't see the puck at all. Well, you always have the top view. Can't see where the puck is at all on that play.
Doesn't help that the Panthers are wearing those third jerseys, but now I believe they've just pointed goal. They have. It is a goal.
Scorpion and Brady 8, Eric Lindros.
Well, did that hit Vernon in the chest?
It may have crossed the plane. See, once the puck crosses that line, even if the goaltender makes a save, it's
right there.
So it's definitely over the line, even though Vernon has possession of that puck.
And obviously, because Vernon's chest is behind the goal line, oh yeah, he made a save. The only problem was after across the goal line. And like Jimmy said, very tough to pick up because the Panthers are wearing those deep blue sweaters, but it's definitely a goal. And Eric Lindros.
Power play payoff contested. Lindros rams into Svela. Here come all the Panthers at Lindros. Simpson and Long Flyers have to get there. LeClair and Gagne get in there. Lindros now has settled on one player. Now another Panther comes in. Now it's Lindros, fresh from a mild concussion with Reed Simpson, who can throw him. Now a left from Simpson, a right from Lindros. Oh, there's a right from Lindros that caught Simpson. Now they're in tight along the boards. Simpson trying to get that left in. Now Lindros has his left free, but Simpson dragging. No, Lindros got a right in underneath, and the linesmen jump in. Other players are milling around as well. Laws is the only one out there who's known for his fistic abilities. Lindros is cut. I believe it was from his helmet. And Lindros hears it from the crowd. He just ran over Svela, and the Panthers, they didn't like that at all, and so they all went after him.
Tell you what, this crowd here is alive.
Oh, and deservingly, they're getting what they want. They love the scoring.
Lindros,
they love the hitting. They love the fisticuffs.
It was a race to Lindros, Simpson and Laws. And the Flyers then got there to help out Lindros to make it one-on-one, and then it just became Simpson and Lindros. Fight of the year for Lindros. Well, he has certainly answered the question about whether he would let his third concussion affect the style of play. He has been extremely physical in this game.
Just run on instinct, like we had talked before, and the instinct there is to take the body, turn around, and all of a sudden everybody wanted to go with him. He just dropped the gloves.
To move back the other way. LeClair in deep center. Lindros shoots! Twin Towers, just like that, take the Flyers from behind, two in front.
There's a guy you just don't want to let the opportunity to wind up. Look, then let it go. I mean, Eric Lindros shoots the puck as well as anybody in the league. And here, he gets the puck, he looks, he sets up, and then has the opportunity to wind up. And certainly with this shot, this was a dandy.
Well, the guy that made the play, John LeClair, see how he's looking right now? There's Lindros in the slot. And the defender actually skated away from him. I think if you look at it again, I don't know if we can see the defender, but he skated right in front of the goaltender and set up a partial screen. But Lindros made absolutely no mistake in that. But hats off to
his captain, Eric Lindros. Eric, first period, one of those seesaw affairs. You got the two to get him back, but you hate to give up that goal late.
Yeah, that was that's tough to swallow. But we're in good shape. We got a bad bounce on their first goal, went off the skate off the side of the net. But those things happen. We battled back. We got a couple of quick ones, and we're treading water right now. We're all even. We're looking forward to the next two.
Eric, John LeClaire really put it right on your stick there. Yeah. And, you know, you used that slap shot. Everybody says that a slap shot is not very accurate, but it certainly wasn't that play. Run us through this one.
Well, the plays made by Jonesy kind of go into the net, and took their defenseman with him, and gave me a nice lane to the net. So when Johnny puts a puck in the tape like that, you got a great chance to score, and got lucky that time, I guess.
Eric, we haven't talked to you about the addition of Keith Primo yet. Obviously, you guys both scoring here in this first period. Talk to us about what the elements that he brings to this club.
Well, he's another guy that's big and strong. He can does real well on his face-offs. He's got a touch around the net. He's not going to take any crap from anybody. You saw what happened with guys like Corson and in the previous game, Simpson. I mean, he's a big, strong man. He looks out for people on the ice as well as himself. And he does it all. I mean, he kills penalties. He'll be on the power play doing a great job. And we had to give up a great friend and a great player to get someone like Keith. But, you know, the trade's worked out.
All right, Eric, congratulations on the goal. Good luck the rest of the hockey game.
Thanks, guys.
Eric Lindros involved with a goal and very physically in this game as well. And here collides with Jeff Hackett. Back with more from the Molson Center. After
there's McGillis thinking about the shot, but instead he flings it in front. It deflects it. They score! Lindros just took a whack at it. It bounced off with Duncan in. After all those chances, a dirty but good goal. And we're tied at 3 on the power play goal.
Eight ball side pocket.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kevin Holler.
That puck was going to go so wide as Lindros had the opportunity to swing around. It came right to him, right to the right of Hebert.
And then all of a sudden, it's LeClaire's skate.
Well, let's take a look.
No.
No way. Not even close. That was Kevin Holler all the way.
Well, McGillis is going to just take the shot on that, but watch this. See that? That puck was going to go straight across the goal crease area, but bang, right off of the skate. How many times have we seen that?